Sagittarius, hello there, my beautiful friends. We're going to do your general tarot reading for early July 2023. Thank you so much for joining me today. You know I appreciate each and every single one of you. So let's get right down to business as usual and start you off with an oracle card here, just so we could dip our toes in energy and see what's going on for the lovely Saggies out there. I hope you're all doing fabulous, my friends. Let's shuffle it up here one time. See what we got for the Saggy collective here, my guides and spirit team. And yeah, we're just going to take a real quick look at this first card, then we'll get into the full reading itself. And at the very end, I'll pull you a bonus card from the Shadowland Tarot, just to see what might be in the shadows or what shadow work you can lean in on, which is always interesting. Let's get it going here. Let's rock. Yeah, the deck is trying to jump out of my hands already. Let's see what we got for you, Saggy. Nice and quick, please, my gods. What's going on for my friends? Thank you. Nice and quick, as expected. So we do have the Helping Hands card. I feel like I've seen this for you in recent weeks. It is one of my favorite oracle cards here. It is lovely, and there's a lot of undertones here, whether it is help, protection, it could also be centering around rest. But before we really start pulling that card apart, if you're new here, I'll be speaking about the July subscriber surprise towards the end, so you might want to check that out. Also, if you could kindly illuminate that like button by tapping it right on its third eye, you know, I'd greatly appreciate it. But enough of the promo, into the reading. Let's talk about this card. So we see this lady, she is having herself a little nap, a little snooze, and she is surrounded by the hands. So first and foremost, when I see this card, I do think of spiritual protection and guidance, whether that be ancestors, guides, angelic energies. This is very love and light filled type of energy, so it is good. So maybe some of you just need to hear it, like you are being watched over, you're being protected, you're not alone, which could be very nice. I also see this card often when somebody feels like they need some help or assistance. So whether it's someone who's wanting your help, maybe you need a hand with something. We're all human beings, right? We're not perfect. Sometimes we need assistance to get through certain things. Or maybe you want to help others. That could absolutely be a beautiful message with this card. There is also a big link here to the rest, sleeps, and like making sure you're getting proper relaxation and recharging when this card shows up. So hopefully you're not having insomnia and stuff like that. But let's just put that card to the side. Let's get into tarot. I always say that first card doesn't make or break the reading. It's just a little footnote. But yeah, I'm going to get you three tarot cards in the upright before we get the intuitive juiciness flowing. So let's shuffle it up here one time here for Saggy, please. My guides, what do we got here in early July? So, last week's reading, just like the week before it, we've had a little bit of emotional volatility surrounding the Saggies. Not saying it was you, but it could be people around you. Last week's reading was titled An Emotional Explosion, and the vibe I was getting was somebody holding something back, holding it back, holding it back, till eventually that overflow happens. So sometimes expressing of one's emotions could be a really good, beautiful thing, but sometimes it could spin a little out of hand. So hopefully that hasn't happened to too many Saggies. Let's see what we have for you this week, though. As you know, energy is very fluid, never set in stone, so only take this how it hits for you, because we could be seeing your vibe or someone you're linked to. Let's get you three cards. What do we got in the ether for my Saggies, please? My guides, talk to me. There we go, first card out, and we have the Strength card. So we're getting a lot of these angelic energies showing up. I do love the Strength card. It is inner determination, it's inner strength. It is someone that can get through a lot of tests, trials, tribulations. Could be a test of strength of some sort. Let's get you a couple more. Thank you. Hierophant, yeah, this energy has been showing up a lot in the fire signs. Powerful, powerful major arcana here for you, Sagittarius. So the Hierophant in position number two. One more. I don't want to speculate too much. Hey, we got our good friend, the King of Cups, aka Kyle of Cups without a beard, showing up himself right here on the back end. So yeah, we got some things to look over here, Sagittarius. Very interesting lineup. Could be a lot of different things happening. Now let's go through one by one. I'll give you some of the classical meanings and archetypes before we get into the juicy intuitive stuff. So at first glance, first look, initially I see the two very powerful major arcana leading us off. These cards normally show up when there are powerful archetypes and threads moving through our lives. Could be experiencing a lot of changes and metamorphosis. We also have the King of Cups back there, which is a card that centers around emotion, like we were seeing last week. Also romance, love. But kings represent control, okay? And the Hierophant is an authority figure as well. So we're seeing this little emphasis on control or authority figures, but let's go through one by one. We'll really start to piece this together. Position number one, the Strength card. for a portion of you, you might be connected to Leo when this card shows up. You see the lion chilling there. Once again, this is an angelic type of energy to me. I know not every reader sees it that way, but this can be very protective, loving, and caring when the strength card shows up. To me, it does talk about fighting one's own demons with love as opposed to brute force. Being kind to yourself is a card I always like to mention this with. Like, you really need to treat yourself with love, treat yourself with kindness when this card is here. The strength card to me can also literally be a test of will, a test of determination, or some sort of test coming in. So I'm really wanting to clarify this card to see what shows up when we have the strength card. Now, moving to the center, we have one of the most complex cards in the whole entire deck. We have the Hierophant. Seems very simple on its face. Okay, you see this papal figure, you see the Pope chilling. To me, this, of course, could represent religion. When I see this, it is linked to Taurus. So you might be connected to one. If not, it is firm. It's immovable. This is a long-standing type of energy. Once again, this is a card of authority figures of any kind. This could represent institutions like corporations. This could represent religious institutions, stuff like that. I normally see the Hierophant when day-to-day life comes up, like your normal day-to-day schedule. This card can easily, when we're talking about relationships, long-term relationships, long-lasting ones like marriages and stuff like that. So there's a lot of things here, but this Hierophant is almost an immovable type of energy and it is extremely slow. So you might be experiencing some delays when the Hierophant shows up, especially smack middle of the spread. Now moving to the back end, we'll get more detail out of that. Because depending on what the clarifier is, it could speak about a big shift or a change. On the back end, we got our good bestest friend, the King of Cups himself. And yeah, maybe I'll draw a beard on him, maybe I won't. But the King of Cups here, once again, water sign energy. So we're thinking Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. If you're not connected to any of those, the King of Cups, as with all kings, represents control of his respective suit. This one is about creativity. This is a card of emotion. It's a card of love. So when we see the King of Cups, very common in love readings, so your emotional state could show up, people that have a lot of love for you, or you having a lot of love for other people when this card is here. But with the energy I've been seeing in the last couple of weeks about a little volatility of emotion, it's interesting that this comes up, especially next to Hierophant. You might be calming something down or getting a grip, depending on what clarifies it. So let's just put this king here. We got a lot to look into, Sagittarius. If this is an energy, your energy, absolutely someone you're connected to is going through quite a bit. Let's go through. And yeah, I want to dive deeper. We're going to jump in and clarify. All right. Shuffle it up here one more time for the Saggies, please. Let's see what we got going, my friends. What's up with Sagittarius? And yes, this is where I go intuitive with the message, which means I just tell you how it feels to me. So feel free to do further research or rely on your base knowledge of tarot. Because as you know, every single reading is about the reader's interpretation, and I'm just giving you mine. Let's go in on that strength card. And yes, if you're a reader yourself, please feel free to play along. That's why the box is here. If you're feeling any messages that you want to give to Sagittarius, you could drop it in the comments. I don't mind at all. All right, strength time. Strength doing here. Thank you. Nine of Cups. Yeah, a lot of you could be going through certain trials and tribulations in this time, and it can be a big test. We have the Nine of Cups in reverse, okay? And I'm getting one of those like, okay, well, you seem to keep it together. You seem perfectly fine when things are going smooth. Let's throw you a little curveball. Like, that's the vibe I'm catching here. Now, I'm not saying if this is someone purposely doing that. If that's the case, that's not the nicest behavior where like somebody like throws a curveball just because things are going smooth. But this could easily just be even spirit testing you, right? The Nine of Cups is usually a card of wish fulfillment. Very loving, welcoming, and giving. The fact that it's in reverse, I mean, it could be some sort of test of solitude as well. Like, all right, can you do something on your own? Can you do it without help? Can you do it without assistance? Hopefully none of you are feeling like a little lonely. When I see this under strength, this card can also represent somebody that always is like willing to give the shirt off their back or just gives too much. So that may be a behavior that you've experienced in the past where you've just given and given and given nonstop and you've always given the most. So spirit might be trying to teach you a lesson in regards to that as well. Like, yes, it's good to be generous. It's good to be giving, but there's always a point. Okay, that's just the vibe I'm picking up here. Aside from that, I would say for a lot of Saggies, like, yeah, Spirit might throw you a curveball. There might be some sort of surprising test or an unexpected test coming up in the coming days and weeks. Nothing to, like, really, you know, ring the alarms about. Let's keep moving over to the Hierophant. It is what it is. I know I just gave, like, several messages there. Only take what hits for you. But let's see what's up with that Hierophant. Please and thank you. And I really want to get over to our good friend, the King of Cups there, see what he's about. So why is this Hierophant here? Thank you. Magician. Good. Wow. Okay, this is a big change for the better, my friends. I really like how this is feeling. We have the Magician in the upright underneath this Hierophant. You might have a lot more control or creative power than you think when we have this. So much control of one's destiny is showing up here on the back end. If you could get over this hurdle that I'm seeing in the front end, if you could get over this test, there could be bountiful rewards and blessings to be had. I'm really feeling that. The Magician in the upright is a card of manifesting, creating, bringing to you what you want, that life that you want. When I see it, once again, one of the other themes of the Magician, aside from being an energetic conduit, it's a card of control, controlling one's destiny, controlling one's future. And under a card like the Hierophant, the King here, I'm just getting someone who has more control than they think, or more power within them than they even realize. And this feels beautiful to me right here in the center. You could be really creating something beautiful, even if you don't realize it. This feels amazing here in the center. So just keep yourself focused, get through whatever test and trial Spirit throws towards you, because there is a lot of beautiful energy to be had here, Sagittarius, a lot of reason for optimism. Okay, you might have so much more control in your life than you think you do. Okay? Even if you know you do, even you might be one of those Sagittarius where, yeah, you know what, I do, I control my destiny, I go where I want, I do what I want. But there might be more in store. That's kind of what I'm getting at here. Big energy of blessings here. Let's go in on the King of Cups. Then we'll do a quick recap before we get into the shadow card. This, it feels good to me, my friends. And I mean, I know we do have this little test in the beginning, but we're picking up steam. We're picking up really good energy here. For some of you, yeah, maybe it's just the Taurus that you're manifesting in or is manifesting you. It could easily be that. But let's go in on the King of Cups here. Let's see what the King has to say for Saggy. Thank you. Yeah, even better. And it's like we've gotten better and better and better. We have the Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, this could be someone that is starting to feel content, or you might be getting to a place very soon where you can feel extremely content and happy. I really love this energy back here. The Nine of Pentacles, maybe some of you, this is a water sign that's just like doing their own thing, possibly, because the Nine of Pentacles is a card of independence. But to me, this is strength on the back end, emotional power, emotional strength. Someone who's like, you know what? I'm fine. I don't need to rely on others to make myself happy. I don't need to rely on this to make myself happy. I don't need outside sources. It all comes from within. This is a beautiful energy we have back here. So there's like this evolution we've been getting, Sagittarius, which I absolutely love. Because yeah, we do have this curveball, this test happening. But then we have someone saying, you know what? I'm going to pass this test and I'm going to control my destiny and future. I'm going to control what I go and what I bring in. I'm going to control how I feel. We have the King, which is water. We have the Nine of Pentacles, which is earth. You combine that, that's blessings. And I'm picking it up. Like after this test, it's like blessing after blessing after blessing. So for a lot of Sagittarius, there could be a lot of good just within reach. This is absolutely beautiful here, especially with this Nine of Pentacles. Very grounded, very firm. Sometimes firm, immovable energy is not a bad thing. This feels like long-lasting happiness. So there could be a lot of really good things in store for the Sagittarius Collective, which makes me happy because I know a lot of beautiful Saggies out there. I really do. So let's go through and do a quick little recap here. Interesting how this got better and better and better as we went throughout, and I like it. If you kindly look in the box before we get to the shadow card, position number one, we have the Strength card with the Nine of Cups in reverse. This was making me feel all sorts of things. First, I was saying, like, yeah, maybe there's been times in the past where you've given and given and given and given. You're always the one that gives and gives and gives. Spirit could be asking you to tone that back and focus on your happiness. Another thing I was picking up here is like that surprising or unexpected test from Spirit where they throw you a little curveball. Now, if it's a person that says, yeah, everything seems fine and smooth, and then they throw a curveball just to get a rise, that's not good. But sometimes Spirit wants to see our progress. In the center, though, I get the vibe of someone really passing these tests with flying colors. We have the Hierophant with the Magician. So much control of one's future and destiny. And I know I spoke about it over and over again. But this, to me, is someone saying, like, you know what? I'm going to control what comes into my life, who and what I allow in. And it could have a big impact on your regular day-to-day life. So spiritual and just really understanding how much power they really have. Okay, so spirit could be asking you to do that. Like, see how much of a creator being you are, how much power you have. Because as we push to the back end, we have the King of Cups with the Nine of Pentacles. Sure, that might just be a water sign you're connected to. It's like doing their independence thing. But a vibe I'm picking up here is the blessings to be had right on the back end. This is extremely powerful, and I love it, Sagittarius. Like, there is changes and long-lasting happiness and blessings to be had. So please take a screenshot if you want to look into it further. Going to get you one shadow card here just to see what's in the shadows. Okay, so what's in the shadows for Saggy, please? I always like to pull this card at the end. And whether it's something that you've been dealing with for a while or whatever it might be, something you might not quite see just yet, I always think it's a nice little insight. So let's see what's in the shadows for Saggy, please and thank you. What do we got? And this deck is acting a little funky. There we go. So the Sun. So even in the shadows, we're getting positive cards here. Now, yes, since it is a shadow reading, of course, I have to read the, you know, inverse of the Sun. Big Leo connectors here, Sagittarius. So I will say this, maybe in the time of Leo, which is kind of right around the corner, there could be some big things coming in for you, big events and such. But the Sun, to me, is the most positive card in the deck. Even in reverse, it's a positive card. But since it's in the place of shadows right now, this can speak about revelation. A lot of Saggies could be having eureka moments, connecting the dots, seeing the big picture. The aha moments could be coming in for a lot of Saggies, which could be a good thing. I would say just brace yourself for that, especially with the Sun in the shadows. But this card does talk about understanding. It is connected to spirit as well. Spirit might want you to really like shine some light on things you may be suppressing when that shows up in the shadows. So Saggy, that's what I have for you this week, my friends. Don't click away just yet, though. I'm going to give the details of the July subscriber surprise. If you got your name in for the June subscriber surprise, the winners will be announced in my community tab after this week's Fire and Air Signs readings. But for July, I'll be giving away two copies of the Everyday Witches Tarot once again, one of my favorite decks and one of the first ones I ever gave away on this channel. So if you'd like to get your name in for this, two simple things as always, my friends. First, you must be subscribed, which I'm sure you already are. And second, let me know down in the comments, out of all the tarot suits, which one has your favorite art style? Is it the swords, wands, pentacles, cups, even the major arcana? You'll be entered to win. And at the end of July, I'll put the winners in my community tab. As always, my friends, much love, and I'll see you soon.